Trinamic. So hot right now. Hi everyone, I'm Tom, and today we're going to take a look at the Trinamic TMC2100 based stepper driver modules made by Vaterot Electronic. These driver modules aren't out yet, but they already got a huge amount of attention because they promise an absolutely silent operation of your stepper motors with a drive mode they call Stealth Chop. It also has the option of interpolating a 16x microstepping input to a 256x microstepping output with a feature called Microplier, and has yet another drive mode, spread cycle, that is closer to what traditional drivers do, but adds some intelligence to the way it applies current to the motor. And that's kind of important for them, as they are not high current drivers like the insane Texas Instruments DRV8825. Officially, they can only handle a permanent 1.2 amp current, which on paper is less than any of the common Allegro or Texas Instruments chips. However, they also have a 2.5 amp peak rating. I'll talk about how that comes into play later on in the video. Now, I'll be getting into some technical details. If you are not all that confident about what all these things mean, I'd recommend checking out both the stepper motors and steps per millimeter videos. I explain a good bit of why and how all this works there. So, the one big feature this driver has is the ability to run a stepper motor at almost zero noise. At that point, the linear bearings and the fans in your printer become the loudest parts. This zero noise mode is what Stealth Chop is all about. The interpolated 256x microstepping is just the icing on the cake and doesn't really make that much of a difference. But basically, using Stealth Chop effectively turns the stepper driver, which usually runs as a constant current driver, into a constant voltage one, making it more similar to what a regular brushless motor or computer fan does. Which means that it's not forcing the motor into position as much, but rather gently suggests that it should now maybe move to that spot, and if it doesn't, well, the driver isn't going to take any extra efforts of getting it there. So while the motor's rotation is going to be very smooth and silent, it's also not going to output any decent amount of torque, especially when accelerating and decelerating. Which kind of makes it pretty much useless for our 3D printers. In my case, with a relatively heavy non-Bowden extruder, but with a fairly strong gearing on the motor, I had no chance of printing anything at decent speeds, and the folks of Delta Maker, who tried these drivers with a super lightweight Bowden Delta, didn't fare much better either. At least they got some basic printing done, but on certain moves, the motors would still skip. And I mean, if you look at the datasheet of these drivers, it states in multiple spots that Stealth Chop is only to be used for low and medium velocities, so preferably for something like quietly opening and closing the fan shutters on air conditioning units, but not for throwing around heavy axes in a 3D printer. So now that we got that out of the way, let's move on to the useful parts of these drivers, and that's basically the spread cycle mode. It works essentially in the same way as any other stepper motor driver, but it promises some intelligent current control. For example, a reduction in current when standing still to keep the motors and drivers cool and save some power, as well as an adaptive control scheme for quick accelerations and higher speed. This is where the 2.5 amp peak rating becomes interesting. Because even if you set the drivers to 2.5 amp peak, which I wouldn't recommend, the idea is that they will rarely need to run at the full current. I got some basic heatsink with these drivers, which, at least for these prototype modules, get taped to the top of the driver chips. The final version will have the entire driver flipped so that you'll be able to attach a heatsink to the actual thermal pad that's on the bottom of the driver chips and thermally available on the opposite side of the board. So if you attach a heatsink to that side, you get significantly better cooling with the same small heatsink. Still, I managed to get a really decent amount of grunt out of these drivers, and while I'm pretty certain that the current output wasn't nearly as high as with my usual Allegro A4988 drivers, the motors actually ended up having more torque. But at the same time, they were still much quieter than the Allegro chips, even if they weren't exactly noiseless anymore. I guess that's mostly a testament to how much the Allegro's current control loop starts to fall apart at higher currents. However, there was still some noise above roughly 1 amp RMS current, and that was due to the fact that the driver starts to run at a lower chopper frequency the more current it needs to apply. Some of you might not hear it, and some motors are more likely to cause it, but in my case there was an extremely annoying high-pitched whine coming from the motors, the same as with the Texas Instruments drivers. Thankfully, there is an easy way of curing that, and that is to simply supply more voltage to the drivers. Or, of course, to use less current, but that's not the point here. For testing, I simply supplied the driver from one of these super cheap boost modules to step up my usual 12 volt supply voltage to 24 volt, and that at least changed the whining to be far less annoying. Of course, this means that you can solder in the 12 volt supply pin on the module, since you're essentially creating a second supply rail. But, and here's the next catch with these drivers, at least for these prototypes, you can't really use the default jumpers or software settings for configuring microstepping and the different drive modes anyways. As they only use two of the MS or MR config pins, they require three different states to toggle through all of the available modes: pull to ground or VCC, or, and this is special to the Trinamic drivers, left open and unconnected. They are still pin compatible with the Pololo modules and will do something if you just pop them in, but to take full advantage of what makes them great, I'd recommend not soldering in the pins for the three config inputs and using jumper wire to connect them to VCC or ground. To use the mode I'd recommend, which is spread cycle with an input 16 to output 256 times microstepping interpolation, you just need to solder a single wire straight across from the first config pin to the ground pin and leave the other two open. The final board will let you configure some of these modes through solder jumpers, but many of the main boards, including the RAMs, rely too much specifically on the Pololo Allegro boards, and even with the extra solder jumper, still can't configure the drivers correctly. So it doesn't make much sense to solder in the extra pins that pass the config signals to the main board anyways. As far as spare pins go, the two pins that were previously sleep and reset, which are functions that never get used, are now a pair of diagnostics outputs. The Trinamic drivers can try to detect when the motor skips and the driver fails for some other reason, and while none of today's control boards support those outputs, it would be a great and simple way of making our printers more reliable should a board manufacturer decide to make use of them. The final boards will also have an extra pin that will allow the mainboard to control the current output of the drivers. Should you have a board that supports this, you can simply ignore the analog potentiometer on the modules and set the current through software. So, in conclusion, these are great little drivers if you look past the mismarketed stealth chop mode. If I had to choose which current driver these most closely compete with, I'd probably say the Texas Instruments DRV8825, since the Trinamic TMC2100 are in a completely different league as the common Allegro drivers. It's not that those don't work, but the Trinamic chips are just better overall. They produce more torque, run with less noise, and have smarter connectivity, even if they are currently not plug-and-play style simple to use. As far as pricing goes, well, there is no definitive pricing of these modules yet, but if they end up costing about as much or a bit less than the DRV8825 boards, I definitely recommend going for the Trinamic boards if you value a less noisy printer or simply want a bit more performance than the Allegro chips can give you. And once the control boards start using the diagnostics pins, things are really going to get interesting. And that's it for today. As always, thanks for watching. Also, check out the video description. I put a few links in there to the things seen in this video. And of course, as soon as these driver boards become available, which should be very soon, there will be a link to them as well. Take care, everyone. See you next time.